Good afternoon, good morning, good evening, and welcome to Poker VR Roundtable with me, Shoggy Wuggy, and it's our Sunday Pokeroo. So glad you could make it. If you are watching live, we want as many comments today as possible. Could you do that for me? Type, 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 tap, tap, tap the screen, and let's get as many comments as we can. First of all, we have got our two guests backstage right now, and before we introduce them to you, I'd like to say a warm welcome to the new members that have joined us here in VR Roundtable. We've now got 102 members from something that started off, okay, we might get 12 or 15 people that we can all chat to. We've now got 102 members, and we are delighted to have everybody. It is a fully inclusive, it's not exclusive, it means everybody on VR Poker is welcome to join. We welcome you. So we'd like to welcome Jamid Jones, I know him as Scott Jones, welcome to the page. Michael Reeder, Leon Schwartz, Paula Constantino, I hope I've got this right, all this. Derek Griggs, Marius has joined us. Ervin, Tommy Chaston, Charlie Rose, Steve Boyce, and is it Milan Norby? Anyway, so welcome all you guys. Don't forget to spread the word about the VR Roundtable. It's a nice landing space that we can all talk and see photographs and actually get to see people dogging because it's Pokeroo. Also, just before we bring on our guests, we'd like to say a big congratulations to one of our members, and that's Auntie Up. She managed to get the coveted green t-shirt, the t-shirt that money can't buy. So congratulations to Auntie Up, and well done to all the members in voting for her to get the t-shirt for being a nice person or being a nice player around the tables. Right, I think we're ready now to introduce this week's guests in Pokeroo. Welcome to the jungle. We are going to welcome, first of all, Big Daddy Joe. Big Daddy Joe, come in. Hello, Daddy Joe.
How you doing?
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
I'm good, Joe. Good to see you. And of course, as well as Big Daddy Joe, we're going to bring on Big Daddy Joe's sidekick. Now, there might be a lot of people that don't know this, but Big Daddy Joe, you have a partner in Poker VR, coming from the same location. And she is, of course, the head admin of the page. Let's bring on Cindy Marie. Hello, Cindy.
What's up?
And Cindy is the first female as well we've had on Pokeroo. So welcome. Thanks, you guys, for being this week's guest.
I'm all female, Shug.
Yeah, all female. And there's Sherry saying, good evening, everybody.
Sherry.
And Newton saying hi to all.
You're
hi,
welcome,
Newton. Give the Newton nod. The Newton nod.
You're welcome.
And Phil saying, oh, Monk Bungler saying, hi, Newton. That is
Mungle.
Our Phil
who.
Yeah. Bungle, yes. Right, so here we are. At last, we've got you live on Pokeroo. We've been threatening for a long time to get you on, and it's great that you're here. So once again, Pokeroo, it's all about having a little chat, finding out about the game that we all love and we get addicted to. But first of all, we want to know where you guys are from.
Go ahead, Joe.
We are from a little city in New Brunswick. It's the capital. Fredericton, New Brunswick, Canada.
Canada, New Brunswick, and is that it there?
That is the city there, yes.
Is that a city on the river?
That's considered a city.
Is it on the river?
Yes.
It's on the river, yeah. The river runs right through the middle of it.
Right, and so is everything, like all the a lot of the leisure stuff built round the river, by the river? Not really?
Yeah, there's a fair amount, yeah.
Right, okay. Yeah. Cool. Right, so you are from New Brunswick. Is it New Brunswick or just Brunswick?
New Brunswick.
So where's Old Brunswick?
Have done yet.
There's no Old Brunswick. Okay. Right. So, Joe, first of all, what do you do for a living? What would Joe be doing on a Monday morning at 11 o'clock?
Playing poker.
Oh, my Oh, so a man of leisure then.
I don't go to work till 3:30.
All right, okay. So let's say that again, Chuck. Joe, what would you be doing at Monday at 5 o'clock at night?
I would be taking care of the city transit buses for Fredericton.
Ah, so when you say taking care, so you clean them?
Clean them, fuel them. It's real bad with this COVID going on because there's extra stuff you got to do. If there's a breakdown, I deal with it. I test drive them. I'm a babysitter.
So you service the buses as well then?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that's a good job. Have you always done that, Joe?
Always, yeah. I've been there almost 23 years. So.
Wow. And you've always been from New Brunswick?
Yeah.
Yeah, cool, cool. Cindy, what about you? 5 o'clock on a Monday, what would you be doing?
5 in the evening?
Mm-hmm.
Cooking dinner for my daughter.
Right, so do you work or are you a housewife?
I am not working at the moment because of this COVID stuff. So.
Right, okay.
I'll be off for a while.
Okay, cool.
No, I get paid for it. It's all good.
That's fine. So what is it? Now, am I right in saying that you used to work in the same place?
Joe and I met at our job, yes. We both worked for the city of Fredericton, and I started in 2005, and I didn't like him.
You didn't like him?
Didn't like him one bit. I could hear him a mile away. He was loud. He was all the time, and it was just annoying. So I didn't really bother with Joe for a while.
Right,
and
okay.
And then he decided to clean me up a little nice one day.
So what brought it on? Who asked who first? Sorry.
Well, it was the expression I get come up with for that brought her over. I looked her right in the eyes and I said, "Ever since you walked into my life," and that was it.
I'm gonna be sick.
Okay, no, that's not true. But we made a bet. Joe and I play at the same bingo hall back then, and he would do that on weekends. So we made a bet one day. And I said, "If I win, you have to kiss me." And I said, "And you win, same thing." So either way, we do it right.
So that's nice. So I guess you've continued the bingo right onto the poker tables.
Bingo shut down right now, but yeah.
All right. Oh, so you think you're playing bingo on when you're playing poker? That's what I'm trying to say.
Oh, yes.
No. Okay, right. So how long have you guys been an item?
This should be good. Go ahead.
Shaggy, really?
Yes.
Usually girls are good at this. 2011?
Okay, so this is still honeymoon period,
No.
Still on honeymoon? No, okay. Shall we move on?
Okay.
Okay. Are you, Cindy, are you from... New Brunswick, is that where you're originally from? No. So where are you from?
I'm from Brampton, Ontario.
Ontario.
I lived there until 2005.
Ah, right, okay. So, and do you prefer the country life?
No.
She's now in the jungle. Can I say that actually Cindy chose this music, didn't you, Cindy?
Love
Guns
it.
And Roses. Yeah.
I don't like the winters here. They're crazy, and driving in it is crazy. Yeah. When you're in a 40-foot bus and you're on a hill, crazy.
Crazy,
so, yeah.
However, I believe you have got a lovely lifestyle, and you stay in the country, you stay in the jungle, am I right? Yeah.
We live on the mountains. Yeah.
Wow.
Go show them, Joe. Is there anything back there?
Can we get a little look around the life of Cindy and Big Daddy Joe? Because I guess he's in the garage. Wow. And is this a recreation park we're getting shown?
This is our backyard.
A backyard? Jeez, it looks like a park.
Well, I do have a daughter.
Yes. We hear Sarah
that's
all the
house.
Time in the background.
That's the back of the house there.
And that's
deck.
The decking. Lovely. Yeah. Lovely jubbly.
There's my car.
Right. So you've got a lot of land there. A lot of land.
Yeah,
that's why the odd time we hear Joe's always cutting the grass. He's out in the lawnmower.
Always.
Got his ride on lawnmower.
He's got a bad fetish.
I think he's just frozen up there. He's lost his internet. Come back in, Joe. There we are. He's back. He's back.
There's a friend in the house. There's a motorcycle.
I love the bike. I love the bike. Now, we advertised today. It said Cindy, Joe, and friends. And the reason we come on at this point is because you guys have got some friends that visit you round about this time. We might be lucky. Tell them all about the friends. What friends is it you have?
Joe Camilo.
Oh, you want me to? We have a bunch of deer that come in that we sort of named and made sort of pets. And that, the problem I had, she wants to bring them in the house in the winter. That's no. But, you know, okay. we have a few deer.
Oh.
We have no moose.
So who is this? Is this the deer?
No.
This is moose. Come on, Shaggy.
That's a moose. We call a moose a mice. Oh, well, is that deer then?
Yeah,
is that
that's
the deer?
Deer, yeah.
That was last year.
That was last year's deer.
Yeah.
Is it the same deer that keep coming back year on year and their families? And
well, the does do. The does and the kids. But the bucks, you know, we had one fella come in. He came in a couple of times in a couple of years in a row. And then all of a sudden he didn't bother coming back again.
Right.
The
does come back, the does and kids. They'll always come back.
Uh-huh. Very good. That's great. So there's a chance tonight while we're live, we might see you feeding the deers if they turn up. Yeah? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Good chance of that. Fantastic. So what about the moose? Do we see the moose?
Not as frequent. Joe does, I don't.
Right. Yeah. Fantastic. Brilliant.
Yeah, they're all over the place.
Great. So, shall we talk about poker, the game we love? Now that we know all about Big Daddy Joe and Cindy. Cindy's probably dreading this bit, aren't you, Cindy?
Whatever.
and personally, I play with you guys all the time on the tables, and I think these are a scream. And Cindy especially comes up with these crazy sayings round the table. And the latest one is, rather than saying, I beg your pardon, it's, and of course, she's, Joe, can you think of any other sayings that Cindy has round the tables? I've wrote down a couple here.
Not I could say on the air, no.
All right, yeah. Well, the big one, of course. Yeah. The big one, of course, she says is, you're welcome.
You're welcome.
You're welcome.
You're welcome. Yeah, you're welcome. Mm-hmm. A word that's been used quite a lot around the tables, it's ham. I can't read one right here.
Oh,
ham.
My God, Shaggy.
Ham. Bam. I can't read that. Sorry? Ham. Hamburgers, yes! Yes! Shut up. I said I wasn't going to mention that. Hamburgers, yeah. So I'm not telling them. They'll find out. They'll find out. And of course, we've had some screams around the tables and some things we do on the game. We like having fun around the tables. Let's ask individually, what do you like best about the game, Big Daddy Joe?
I just like the socializing of it. You get to meet a lot of different people on there. You get to play a lot of cards, and you get to see a lot of chips pass hands, which usually all end up in your hands. But you know, that's all you know, yes.
They end up in Jose.
Jose, yeah, Jose Rivero, Jose, yeah, mm-hmm. yeah. So the social aspect as well. But Joe, you're competitive. You do the tournaments and. You're climbing, your trophy's climbing, you're starting to get a bit of a stack, yeah?
Yeah. But so it's all about the fun, I guess. It's all, you know, you get in, you get to hear people, the conversations, like, you know, razzing each other. And it's just a good laugh. It's a good laugh. Like
You
know, you feel better when you get done.
Right, okay. Cindy. Cindy, what about you? What do you take out of poker VR? What would I take out? What's the best for you? What do you enjoy best about Poker VR?
I made a couple friends. Okay. That I feel comfy around.
Just two friends, right? Okay. I've got about 20. You've got two. That's fine. You've got to start somewhere.
Man, I'm gonna kick your ass. So a few people. Yeah. Okay. Is that better?
Yeah.
Sherry and I were like sisters from another mister.
Yeah. Yeah.
You are always entertainment.
Yeah.
Of course, Newton.
Yes.
I gotta put him in the silent one. Never trust the quiet ones.
Yeah, you've got to watch the quiet ones, definitely. Mm-hmm.
I like it because it's just, time goes by, it's boring that, you know, when you're home and there's people you can flap and laugh.
Yeah, and we do have fun. And of course, Cindy, your trophy's moving up as well. I've watched your game come along very good too. It's getting there. You've started now to read the flops and read the hands, and yeah, you're coming on. Yeah, did you play poker before you came on to VR?
I played blackjack, not poker. No.
So this was your first experience of playing Texas poker. Mm-hmm. Wow. What about you, Joe? Were you a poker player before you came online?
No, I played before, but not as much as I have lately.
Yeah, I think the advantages of the VR poker, as Joe said, we see so many hands, lots of hands pass.
Yeah.
And I had a conversation, I can't remember who it was I was speaking with, it was just this morning or yesterday, and they were saying that people complain about the algorithms, saying it's all mixed up and set up. In fact, it was Newton, and Newton says, well, Shuggy, we're seeing probably 8 or 9 times more hands if we were playing a live poker game.
Yeah, that's true.
By the time you deal with the cards, by the time everybody puts their chips in, by the time everybody looks at the cards, decides if they're going to bet, then once it's over, by the time it takes to shuffle the cards and start dealing again, we've already saw nine games have passed.
Yeah.
So maybe it's just highlighted more, the speed of the game, and people go on about the logarithms. I'm not convinced. However, I've got an open mind. I just enjoy it for what it is. So, dislikes about the game, because we've asked everyone that's come on to Pokeroo what they don't enjoy about the game. Is there things that really grate at you or you think could be improved, Joe?
That could be improved?
Yeah.
I don't know. I really enjoy what I have going now.
Yeah.
Some of the attitudes could change. That's about it in the poker room.
Are you going to name any names? No names?
No, but it's funny how people will react behind a computer screen or the Oculus compared to if they were sitting at a table with somebody.
Yes.
Some of the stuff that's been said or it's been done, it takes away from the fun that you want to have.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Cindy, what's your dislikes of the game?
Oh, there's this guy on the table named Shuggy. He's pretty crazy.
He's an asshole. can you understand the way he talks? Because I think you've got a detection with that stupid accent that he has.
Let's hear the American accent, Shuggy.
Yeah, we done that last night. I started speaking American, and all of a sudden, Cindy could understand every word I was saying, man. It was so good. I didn't have to repeat myself. She got it going on, that girl. Yeah. Hell yeah.
That's
I could
right.
do that. So, we asked you what you did not like about VR poker. We want an answer. What do you not like about it?
Okay, to you diamond players out there, I do like coming in once in a while and playing with you guys and laughing and listening to the good tunes that are playing. But please don't judge what I play. I hate that.
Yeah.
I can't believe you won that with a 7-3.
Yeah. Yeah.
So what? So be it. Every hand is good before the flop, buddy. Remember that.
Even after the flop. If you want to gamble and risk your chips right up to the river with a 7-3, so be it.
Mm-hmm.
So be it. And do you know what, Cindy? I think I agree with you. I do. I can be a hypocrite, but I think I probably do agree. Because that gives us some kind of inferior complex, thinking, well, I felt it. Poker is about feeling it in the gut. You feel it. You feel as if, yeah, these cards are going to work for me. Doesn't obviously work all the time, but you got to go with your instincts. And, yeah, to be judged on your instincts and how you feel about cards, why should you?
Yeah, let me play what I want to play. Leave it alone.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. What else? What else do you think that you're not so keen on?
That's it. I don't like nasty-ass people.
Yeah.
But, you know, can you name any? I'm looking to back me up there.
I'm looking for names. Come on, spill the beans. Let's have a fight. Come on, give us some names. I've named mine. I've only got one enemy. One enemy on VR Poker. I even like the Green Llama. I sat and spoke to him for an hour. I like him. I like people. But there's one person I don't. And I'll name him. Lyrical Beast. Away you go, beastie.
I don't know him.
I know. Well, that's the only one I didn't like. I like everyone else. It is what it is. And we're not there to argue. We're there to have fun. Because remember, it's a game. End of. It's a game. It's a social game, but it's a game at the end of the day. So, what about the actual makeup of the game? Is there anything you would change within the makeup?
Yes.
As in, what?
Yeah, that's right, Sherry. You go, girl.
Yeah, that's my girl.
Yeah. I would change colors. I would like to see a brighter room.
Okay.
I would like to see people use their hands without going to the quest site. Mm-hmm. And I would like to see more clothing and hairstyles. Like, this hairstyle is not there.
That's your new hairstyle. Yep.
This is new. Chopped up.
Yep. Very good. All chopped up. Looking good, Cindy. So, yeah, the female wardrobe isn't good. I mean, it's Joe, if you look at your missus on Poker VR, does that do anything for you?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Oh, yes.
Oh, my God, Shuggy.
Yeah, how you doing? You know what I mean.
But, yeah, the girls should have their own wardrobe. They're wearing guys' clothes. They should have dresses and stuff. They should have dresses. Yep. I agree with you, Cindy. I think the girls should have a better wardrobe. And they should have accessories for the girls.
Ooh.
Can you think of any accessories?
Listen, I know where you're going with this. And we are not talking, thank you, Queen Essential, about butt plugs. I'm sorry. It's just not a thing.
Aha, aha, aha. Somebody likes the new haircut, Facebook user. And there's our James. He's heard the comment about female wardrobe by others. So, yeah, James has heard that comment. It's pretty true. Yeah. I've got to mention the BP word, right? I have to, because I got the blame of it. And I'm saying it because Joe is facing me, right? Joe, this has been my most embarrassing moment on Poker VR. For some reason, we're at the table and Quintessential mentions butt plugs. So Cindy, being Cindy, very innocent, was intrigued with this word butt plugs, and Sherry knew all about it for some reason. I don't know why. Mm-hmm. But all of a sudden, Joe, you were there. You went on the table. You must have been cooking dinner or something. But we just seen the head going back. Joe, what's a butt plug? Shuggy's talking about butt plugs.
Yes.
Joe, I never said a word. I never said a word. And I felt my face going really, really red. Joe is going to think that I'm talking to his missus about fucking butt plugs. When it was Queen. So I'm actually getting embarrassed talking about it right now, but because you're a lovely guy, Joe. But yeah, that was weird that night. It was strange. And then people coming in, the conversation kept going on, and it's still going on.
Yeah.
It's still going on.
Yes.
Joe, you look excited.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. But I think that night when she hollered and said that it was you that wanted to know about it, is she wanted to know about it.
And
then when she found out, there was an order put in.
Look at her face.
What? Oh, my God. No, there wasn't.
There, Jim's saying, you two look nice. Ah, two, I mean. Yeah, there we go. How good's that?
Thank you, Jim.
Oh, thanks. Sorry. He just had to lower my volume. That was me. Sorry, shouting probably for the Joe. But it was a shouting moment, that one. Yeah. Wow. Wow. So, yeah, we did. We spoke about the BPs. They said we wouldn't do it, but yeah. And also, way back at the start when I first befriended yous and Cindy, there was a song that I started playing because I when I went on holiday, I always remember.
Holy shit! You're just throwing it all out, aren't you?
I know, but I'm not playing it, don't worry, because I did promise you 4 weeks ago now, so I'm never going to play this song again. But it was a song, it was a Caribbean song called Ride Me Cindy, and it was like a party song.
Oh my God.
But it didn't have the connotations that, and I'm thinking, oh no, I've made a mess of this. Mm. So when people come on the tables, we ask them what your song would be. So what would be your song? There you go. If you had an intro song, what would it be? Big Daddy Joe, if you were to have an intro song for the Heavyweight World Poker Contest, what would your entrance music be?
I've never really thought of it that way. I'll never get that way.
I can't see nothing.
Never. Yeah,
Sherry, she forgot all about that song. Sherry did.
Keep forgetting about it.
I sing that song to you.
I think it's a good song. I think it's a nice song. Cindy, what would be your entrance song?
The Game by Motorhead.
The Game? Oh, don't know that one. The Game. Cindy, talking about the page, are you surprised about how popular it's turned out to be? Is there anything you would change about the page, or is it going the way that you envisaged?
I think everybody's doing a great job on it. Everyone's being great, nice, polite, showing most people are showing photos.
Yep.
Keep showing your photos. You want to show something on vacation or you want to do something like that, you're more than welcome. It's going well. Everybody, it's a good place to meet up and talk.
Yeah, and
chat.
Of course, we're...
Get to know each other.
Yeah, we're keeping it positive. All positive. Only positive comments is what we want on the page.
Chat.
And it has been. It has been positive. There's enough negativity in this world. Are they there? Is the deer there?
What?
Is it deer there? Yes. Yes, we're getting deer. We'll give Joey's full screen. Oh, man. Hold on. Wow. This is the back garden. Look at that. Maybe I've put the music on too loud.
Come here.
Wow. She'll come right to him.
Come
this
here.
Is wild deer. Wild deer. Oh, dear.
Hey, mama.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
Any babies out there, Joe?
Nope. Okay. Last year's kid.
And that's their feed. They get supper.
And you just go and buy the feed for the deer?
Yeah. Twice a week.
Twice a week? Wow.
In the wintertime, sometimes three times. Yeah.
Look at that. Wow.
And that's the deer.
Wow, hold on. Wow, that is stunning. It's happened. The reason we went on it this time was to try and catch the deer coming in for a bite to eat, and we managed to get it. That is just amazing. Absolutely gorgeous to have a backyard like that with wild deer coming to feed. Just stunning, stunning. I'm really, 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 really jealous of you guys because he's got a nicer motorbike than me, and his wife and his wife plays poker. My wife doesn't play poker. Although I'm trying to get her to play. We've got the two headsets, but she doesn't play. But we'll work on her. So I think. We're just about to wind up. Before we go, we are trying to organise this meetup in 2022.
Yes.
I think I think we would have a blast. Now, think about it. We've got 102 members on the page. For the people that have just joined us, and there's a lot of joined us over the last couple of weeks, might not know what we're trying to organise. It's early, early days, very, very early days. But what we're trying to organise, you tell them, Cindy, while I play about with my buttons here. Here you go, you tell them. There you go, Cindy.
You nasty man.
You tell them, Cindy.
I don't know nothing about the Caribbean cruises.
It's on you, Cindy. There you go. It's on you, Cindy.
Get on a boat and party.
Yeah. There you go, Cindy. Keep going, Cindy. Keep going, Cindy.
Listen, you're up to no good, you little shit.
Right, okay. Right. Yes. So, for the new people that have just came on, we spoke about, well, wouldn't it be great if all the players from all over the world could meet up and have a bit of a convention. So we spoke about it, then the admin team had a little chat about it, and our admin team, tell Cindy, who's on the admin team, tell them all who we have.
Okay, Jose and Ken are moderators.
Well, Jose Big and Ken Davis Vision House.
Oh, I gotta say, oh, okay. Yeah. Sherry the Dane is an administrator. Shaggy Wuggy is an administrator. I myself, Cindy Marie 70.
Cindy Marie, yeah.
Is an administrator.
Right. Where did the number 70 come from in the name Cindy Marie?
Oh, my brave man. Okay, the year I was born.
All right. Okay. Okay. Well, mine's a Shoggy Woggy one.
One butthole? I don't know.
I don't know. I don't know.
You're Shoggy Woggy one. But
yeah, Big Joe 66. So that was the year you were born as well, then, Joe, 66.
It was.
Very good. Yeah, cool. Okay, so we spoke about having a meet up, and then it took legs, and I thought, do you know what? There's people coming from the other side of the world. Let's make it a 7-day cruise. So we're looking into having a 7-day cruise. Ken's brought on board to try and get prices. If there's any other members as well that maybe can get massive discounts for a group booking, when we find out an itinerary, we're thinking maybe April, May of the year 2022, round about then. Mm-hmm. I know you guys have never been on a cruise. I've been on a few. It's going to make it better value for money that we can enjoy what the cruise ship and the ports have to offer. And then at night time, we can have nice food and then sit down and play live poker. And after the live poker, we can all go to casinos or whatever you want to do. Or party.
Any strip poker?
No strip poker apart from cabin 387. I think Ken told me it was 387 that Ken was organising that. That's not my department. Okay. I start to get embarrassed when we go into these subjects.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Yeah, so we're very much at the planning stage and getting all the details together, and hopefully we can get some really good prices that people might fancy coming on board with us. And I think at the last count, I think I counted people that showed an interest was about, in total, about 15, as in 15 Ooh. Bodies, awesome. Talking families into touch. So listen, see if you get 6 people, I think it's still worth doing.
Oh, yeah.
And it's worth advertising it on the page, because we can have a game of poker with 6 people, easy peasy, all day long. If we have 12 people, we have 2 tables, we have a tournament. And the kind of poker we're going to play is going to be like our tournaments that we have in VR poker. So it might be maybe one day, every day we'll have a big tournament, and it might be a $50 buy-in. So for $50, you get 20,000 chips.
Okay. Hook it up. Let's do it.
And the winner takes first place and a second place. So they get the cash back. And then if you get put out that tournament, you can play a side table with 3 or 4 players, and it might only be a $5 or a $10 buy-in to get 10,000 chips, and you play a little tournament within your own table. So you're not playing cash games. We're not going to use credit cards and gamble our lives away with cars going and lovely motorbikes. It's fun money. No. Money that you would have spent probably putting in a slot machine. But we can have hours of fun round a poker table. So, So that's what we're planning, and it's great that you guys are definitely signing up to that and would come along. I think we would have a ball, definitely. Yeah.
Oh yes.
Yeah. Yep. So just before favorite players, just before we go, I think we've said that favorite players, we all seem to have our favorite groups that we play in. People come on the table, you avoid them. I'm just thinking of more recently things that we've done on the tables. Yesterday, last night, we have some fun. We done the language challenge last night.
You were so crazy.
Yeah. So there was six of us at a table. One person left. Five of us at the table, and we said, the next person that comes in, we're all going to speak a crazy language and acknowledge each other as if we were understanding each other. And that worked, didn't it? The guy came in and looked at us as if, what the is this? So that was one of the challenges. The next one, and this worked on poor Bruce from Guatemala. We done it on Bruce. We never ever told him. We never told you, Bruce. The mic's not working challenge. Cindy, tell them what happened with Bruce. The mic's not working. Tell them.
Yeah, he came in and we were acting like we couldn't hear him. And then Sherry said, you know, maybe you should go out and come back in. And he did. He really left the table and came back in. That was funny.
Yeah. Bruce, your mic is working now, Bruce. That was great. But his mic was working perfectly. Poor Sherry told him, you need to go out and come back in. And he did. And Bruce is a lovely guy. Bruce is a lovely guy too. Yeah, he's a lovely man. Nice man. Also, I was thinking the next challenge we should do, we might even try it tonight. If there's five people at the table and one person comes in, everybody just stops and stares at them.
Okay, let's do
it. Just stares. Oh, I've just had a Facebook warning. Your video is blocked because it may include music owned by someone else. That's because I'm playing Guns N' Roses. Would you believe that? I'm getting the Facebook police. I don't know if they've stopped this broadcast. So I should have been playing this. They're not going to stop me for playing that, but yeah. Guns N' Roses. Oh, there's Bruce. He's not wrote anything, but he's listening. Oh! His keyboard isn't working.
Log off your computer. Come back in.
Yeah, Bruce, your keyboard's not working. Fantastic. Yeah. Listen, you two, for me, are a bundle of fun, and we feel the energy from you around the tables, and it's a brighter place since you have been involved in the VR round table. Realise it's a privilege, and I can't wait to meet both of you in person, especially Big Joe. We'll go away at the barn, play golf, and you can go shopping, Cindy. So
you can play golf on a boat?
Yes, they have golf simulators as well. They do have golf simulators, and there's nothing to say that if we stop at a port, we could jump on a golf course for 3 hours and, you know, while you go to the shops. Yeah, nothing to stop us doing that. Yeah. So, it'd be brilliant. Anyway, I might come to Canada before then. You might come to Scotland before then. Who knows?
Whatever happens.
Every day is a learning day. At this point, I would like to thank you very much for taking the time, especially to you, Cindy, because you're a little bit wary of being the first female on Pokeroon. You've done brilliant. Although you did panic a little bit when I done that and put you on the full screen yourself. You didn't really like Shut that, me. Did you? I know, I'm sorry. big Joe can handle it. He's a man. Look at that. Look at that happy face. Give us a song, Joe.
You don't want that.
He'll dance. Oh, don't play anything.
He'll dance, yeah. Because they were... Oh, there's Muckle View on as well. There's little Muckle View from Oban. Muckle View. Hi, Muckle View. So, Joe was threatening to wear a mankini. Yeah,
he was threatening to wear the mankini
for this Pokeroo challenge. But yeah, it's been great fun, guys. We're going on the poker tables now. I'm going to get my dinner. Actually, it's kept late. So, once again, thanks very much. And we'll see you around the tables. Give me your chips. So thanks for coming.
See you later.
See you later, guys. Bye-bye. Aren't they a lovely couple? There you go. Cindy Marie and Big Daddy Joe. Fantastic. Thanks very much for joining us. Don't forget, if you want to take part in Pokeroo, then why don't you contact me? Give us a wee shout. Say hello, Shuggy. I want to be part of Pokeroo, and we'll get you on in the next couple of weeks. I can tell you that next Sunday, we have got Chi-Town Romeo. He's going to be joining me on Pokeroo. And once again, you can double up with each other. So you can come on with one of your friends. Just like 2 weeks ago, we had Monk Bungler and our good friend, Sasso. So you can double up. But next Sunday, at the same place, same time, maybe even earlier, probably earlier, we'll have Chi-Town Romeo. So from myself, Shuggy Wuggy, have a great week on the tables. I will be doing catch-up probably Wednesday, because this Tuesday, I'm actually playing on Trump Golf Course in Scotland, and I might do a little live to say hello from that great American man's golf course in Scotland. Have a great week round the tables, and don't forget, folks, give me your chips. Give me your chips. Give me your chips. Give me your chips.